morning, Church of God. Parang tulog pa. Good morning po. Amen. Could we just give God our very best clap offering again this morning? Amen and amen. And it's once again February. At makita mo nga yung tabi mo, meron ka bang ka-date sa Tuesday? So kung wala kayong ka-date, this is the perfect place na nandito kayo kasi pag-pray nyo na mamaya. So pag lumapit kayo sa altar call, pag-pray nyo na, isabay nyo na rin. But right now, we're gonna talk about God's Word, and are you excited to hear God's Word today? Amen. And once again, if we're excited to hear God's Word, we'll just give God our very best clap offering again. Amen and amen. Before I proceed with God's Word, I would just like to show you a video first. So let's please roll the slide.
Ain't too sure what I believe in, but I believe in what I see. And when I close my eyes, I see my whole life ahead of me.
Today? Amen? Are they awesome? Amen. Pakitanong katabi mo, are you awesome? Amen. So we are awesome. People are awesome. And alam niyo po, yung mga tao na yun, grabe yung mga ginagawa nila. They are doing unbelievable things. But they were able to experience all those things because simply they tried to do it. They believed that they could do it. And that's why they were able to do it. And nakakaingit po. Why? Because they were able to live life to the fullest. Tama po ba yun? Amen. So sa mga ginawa po nila, may nagawa po ba tayo kahit isa dun? So parang nakakatakot, unbelievable, parang kaya ko ba gawin yun? But you know what? How did these guys get to enter their doors of experience? So this is our title for today because the movie, the video that we showed a while ago, those are so many experiences na sana ako rin ma-experience ko. And those guys, those ladies, those men, how were they able to enter in their doors of experience? Because they've lived an awesome life. And I would like to lead you in God's Word in John chapter 21, verse 1 to 2. You know what? There's a new experience in town once again. In the time of the disciples, this is what happened. In the next verse, it says, after these things, Jesus showed himself again to the disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. And in this way, he showed himself. Jesus Christ showed himself once again to the people. To whom? To Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples were together. So at this time, Jesus was once again back. Why? Because three days before, si Jesus Christ ay namatay na. He was crucified, he was buried, but you know what happened? After 3 days, he risen from the grave. Tama po ba yun? He was resurrected from it. You know what? Right now, this is an unbelievable experience. Tama po ba yun? So may kaibigan na po ba kayong na-resurrect from the dead? So wala pa, di ba? So this is the one-time experience, once-in-a-lifetime experience, an unbelievable experience. And you know what? This experience, Jesus wants to share it with his people. Jesus wants to open it, this experience, to his disciples. So what was happening at the time, in verse 3, it says, Simon Peter said to them, I am going fishing. They said to him, we are going with you also. They also went out immediately, got to the boat, and that night they caught nothing. Kuya ba medyo pumuputok? I need a wireless na lang. Thank you. So, all right. So, what happened again? So, let me read the verse again. Simon Peter said to them, I am going fishing.
They said to him, "We are going with you also." They went out and immediately got into the boat, and that night they caught nothing. And you know what? For the previous years, kasi, the disciples, sanay sila na, they just keep on following Jesus. Whatever Jesus would tell the people, yun yung gagawin nila. Wherever Jesus goes, they would go there. But right now, hindi pa po nila nakikita si Jesus. They are not with Jesus yet, and the disciples were doing nothing. But in spite of that, there was this one disciple whose name is Peter, and this Peter opened a door. And he opened a door to do something. Sabi niya, inaya niya po yung mga other disciples, "Let's go fishing." Why? Because in this time, in this life, minsan kasi there's no leading from the Lord. Tama po ba yun? Do you get to experience that? You don't know what to do today. You don't know what to do tomorrow. You don't know what to do for the next days to come. But you know what? It's better to start on something. Kahit maliit man yan, it's better to start on something kaysa doing nothing. Tama po ba yun? And I remember the time when my dad was putting up a church. Ito po yung itsura ng Church of God, Das Marinas before. So that's the original building. And you know what? This land, it's a vacant lot. We bought the land and wala pa pong nakatayo dyan. But you know what? My vision po yung dad ko to put up a 7-story building, a 5-story building. So after a few months, ganito na po yung naging itsura niya. So the structural was being prepared, the foundation was being prepared. And you know what? That was last 2009. It started at 2009, and the vision for it to be accomplished should look like this. So yan po ang vision for Church of God, Das Marinas. Maganda po ba? Amen. So, amen. Sige, palakpakan po natin si Lord for that. That's the final design of Church of God, Das Marinas. But until now, so about 8 years already, hindi pa rin po tapos yung building. So still in the structural for the past years. And you know what? Sometimes it's like that. When you start to open a door, when you start on something, it may be small or whatever, sometimes hindi sure kung may taong sasama sa'yo. It's not sure if the investors will go with you. It's not sure if the people will go with you and build that building. And even if they go with you, just like the disciples, they went into fishing, it's not sure then that whatever you started would come instantly in fruition. Hindi kagad siya magbe-bear fruit. But you know what? Here's the thing. In the next verse, it says, "But when the morning had now come," wala kasing huli yung mga disciples, "Jesus stood on the shore. Yet the disciples did not know that it was Jesus." They had no idea that it was Jesus. "Then Jesus said to them, 'Children, have you any food?' And they answered, 'Honestly, we have none.'" So yan po, nakita po ni Jesus yung kanilang pinagdadaanan. And you know what? If you started something small, kahit anong start mo ngayon, small or big, but kung ano mang inopen mo na door, I could assuredly say to you that Jesus sees the small start of your life today. Amen? Amen. And when Jesus sees that small start, that small step that you open that door, you know what? I believe that He could open it as a door of experience for your life, and you're gonna do awesome things for the Lord. Amen? Amen. Sige nga po, palakpakan muna natin ng Panginoon for that. And before we proceed with God's word, let us all bow our heads and let us pray. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord God, we just invite your presence, Lord God, to be in this place. Lord God, we don't want to do this by might nor by power, but only by your Spirit. Lord God, we welcome you in this place. Holy Spirit, move in our midst, move in our hearts. Open our hearts, open our minds, Lord God, that we may receive your word. And Lord Jesus Christ, here are your people wanting, Lord God, for an open door for their life today. And Lord God, alam ko po na hindi mo pagdadamot yung sa kanila. We love you so much, Lord God, and we claim the victory. We give you back all the glory and all the praise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everybody shout, amen and amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. So you know what? I would just like to give a testimony on that. Na does really God see that small start that we have? And does He bless it? Does He do something with it? You know what? Last year, ganito na po yung itsura ng Church of God, Das Marinas. So, okay na po yung structural foundation niya, and we're trying to build it one floor at a time. But you know what? Matagal po yan. 8 years na medyo natenga kasi there's a limited of funds. But you know what? Last February 1, we were already able to finish the second floor, and now it looks like this. So, meron na po tayong gym facility in the second floor, a high-end facility, techno gym po yung mga gamit. So when you apply in this gym, a 500 limited membership, you get to help build the church. Why? Yung funds po niyan, matatapos mo yung 5-story building. And not only that, on the other side, on the second floor pa rin, there's a recreational center kasi there. There's a place for the youth to play table tennis, may mga billiards, may PlayStation 4, may Xbox, all the facilities you need for the youth. So para nagbubulungan, tara, lipat na tayo sa COG Dasma. So huwag niyo po akong iwanan dito. Ha? So, gagawin din natin yan dito next time. May ganyan din tayong vision. So the name of the floor is Persian, which means perspire with a mission. Because it was the vision of my dad na why not? Kasi yung mga youth sa Cavite, sa Dasma, they're outside the streets. They're playing their own sugalan there. They're doing their vices in the streets. They're doing drugs in the streets. So sabi niya, why not bring the youth inside the church? Kung anong pwede mong laruin sa labas, dito ka na lang sa loob ng simbahan at dito tayo magkaroon ng fellowship at nakakapagsamba pa tayo kay Lord. So that was his vision. And grabe, as you perspire, meron ka pang mission na na-accomplish in your life. So I'm just really proud of my dad, of my parents, especially of Church of God Las Breñas, kasi their vision came into fruition dahil sinamahan po sila ng ating Panginoon. Amen po ba yun? Amen. Sige po, let's give God our clap offering. So may patotoo na sa ginagawa ni Lord for our lives, and ganun din kaya ang mangyayari in the life of the disciples. So in verse 6, it says here, "And Jesus Christ said to them, cast the net on the right side of the boat." So inuutusan niya yung disciples, ihagis mo yung net sa kabilang side, and you will find some. So these disciples, they don't know yet that who is speaking right now is Jesus. They had no idea. They think that Jesus is just an ordinary man. Hindi si Jesus yun. And right now, as we get to enter our doors of experience, who wants to enter their doors of experience today and live an awesome life? Of course, you want to enter into that doors of experience. But the question is, what locks our doors of experience? So baka po kasi nandiyan na yung doors of experience in front of us, pero baka nakalock. So ano po yung pwedeng mag-lock sa ating doors of experience, just like what happened in the disciples? They could tell Jesus, "Who are you to tell us to cast our net? Are you a fisherman? Are you better than us? We are disciples of Jesus Christ. We are fishers of men. We are fishers and this is our job, mag-fishing talaga. And who are you to tell us?" Sometimes this locks our door when our hearts is full of pride. Pakitanong nga yung katabi mo, may pride ka ba dyan? So kapag may pride kasi, it locks our door of experience in our lives. Kasi taas ng tingin natin sa sarili natin, we think that we are always right. We think that other people could not tell us what to do. Why? Because I'm right. I'm good, I'm excellent, I'm the best at where I am at right now. Or the disciples could also think of Jesus, "Who are you to tell us to throw the net on the right side? Lord, bro, sabi niya, sanay na kami sanay namin itapon yung net namin sa left side. Why in the world will I throw it on the right side? Give me an answer." So minsan po, that's what locks our door of experience when we have this critical thinking. Masyadong critical yung mind natin na bago tayo sumunod, kailangan may facts, kailangan based sa science, kailangan may theory, kailangan may historical basis yan, kailangan may related literature to prove it, kailangan lahat ng solutions naka-ready for us to just follow. Eh, kaya lang po, when we have that critical mind pala, it locks our door of experience. And finally, Jesus told them, throw it and you will find some. So the disciples could tell Jesus, "How sure are you that we will find some? How sure are you that we will catch fish if we throw that net on the right side?" And sometimes we're really dependent on reality. Diba talagang dun tayo nagbe-base, dun lang tayo sa kaya nating paniwalaan. Pag hindi masyadong realistic, we close our doors. We don't enter it. We don't follow. So this combination, this formula, when you have pride, when we have a critical mind and we're very used to basing our lives on reality, it locks our door of experience and nothing happens in our life. Buti na lang, the disciples didn't have these three things. That's why what did they do in verse 6, the next verse it says, "So they cast it out and now they were not able to draw it in because of the multitude of fish." So when they just followed, they took their prides off, they took out their critical thinking off, they took their reality off. What did they do? They just followed. And grabe, Grabe talaga, they received the blessing. They received a multitude of fish. And that's what happened. And in their time, kasi they were doing nothing, there will come a time kasi in our lives that we're gonna be so desperate for a catch. Tama po ba yun? That you feel in your life, masyado na tayong based sa reality, masyado na tayong based sa facts. Wala na nangyayari sa ating life, and it will come to a point na, sige na nga, gawin ko na lang kung anong pinapagawa sa akin. And what's the key? What's the key to unlock the door? What's the key para matanggal yung pride, yung critical thinking, and that reality? The key is simple, which is to simply believe. Simply believe. Pakitap nga yung katabi mong right now. Simply believe. Sabi mo, simply believe. That's all we need right now is to simply believe. And patotoo na po yung disciples, when they simply believed, wow, they caught a multitude of fish. And I would like to share you another testimony. You know what? The Church of God World Missions, and may project po sila na send the lights to cities. So ano pong send the lights to cities? E galing po to sa international, galing po to sa Church of God headquarters. And you know what? This initiative of Church of God is to help 10 cities all over the world. So there are 183 churches, and they chose 10 cities to help to support. And whatever they need, if they need materials, if they need training, if they need finances, they're gonna raise up funds to help these churches. So ito po yung mga some of the churches, the 10 cities that they chose. They chose a church in Amsterdam, Bangkok, Georgetown, places, cities in Africa, in Mexico City, in Moscow, in Paris. So yan po yung mga some of the cities they looked at. So for the past weeks, for the past months, they've been roaming around the world and visiting these cities to check on how they could help on the cities. So siguro po nagtatanong yung iba, bakit 9 lang yan? Kala ko ba 10? So nakita ko yung iba nagtatanong, kasi why? Praise God, why? Because out of all the 183 churches in the whole world, kasama po yung Manila sa kanilang napili in this initiative. Sige po, palakpangan po natin si Lord. You know what? Out of the 638 churches in the Philippines, out of the 30 churches in Manila, you know what? We're blessed, so blessed that Church of God Marriott Manila po ang napili nila to pour out their initiative in the Philippines. And I was able to meet with them last week. And it's just amazing. Why? Because yung mga ginagawa po natin aligned po sa vision nila. They want the churches to go into the city because the people are in the city. So yun po yung ginawa natin 2 years ago, and nabe-bless po sila. And what did they tell us? You know what? This Church of God Marriott Manila will be a model church for all the church planters in the whole world na mga Church of God. So yan po ang ating impact po. Yan po ang ating nasimulan. And what could I tell you right now? Who would have thought na may ganito palang dadating? 2 years ago, it was just a vision from God to go into the city to plant a church. And naghanap din po tayo, we spied the land, and si Marriott Manila lang po ang nag-open for us. That's why nandito po tayo. But you know what? I didn't do any feasibility study. I didn't do any so much research as a basic research or any solution. What did we just do when we went here to Marriott Manila? We simply believed. That's all we did. We simply believed. And who would have thought 2 years later, today, there will be this initiative who will support us in what we've started. Amen po ba dun? Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. And God is really good. And God is really blessing our what we have started. And thank you as well to all of you. For you also simply believe. That's why you are in this place. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. So what happened then? In the next verse it says, in verse 7 to 8, it says, therefore, the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, it is the Lord. Now when Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he put on his outer garment, for he had removed it, and plunged into the sea. But the other disciples came in the little boat, for they were not far from the land, but about 200 cubits, dragging the net with fish. So this is how it looks like. Ito po sila, yan po yung mga disciples, and may tumalun po. Si Peter jumped out of the boat, but the rest of the disciples remained in the boat. They remain in the boat. Why? Because yung fish. Paano yung fish? Paano yung blessing? And this is what happens. Yan po yung tsura nila. So, tingnan po natin, sino po ba tayo dyan? Are we Peter or the rest of the disciples? But what happens? What is our instinct when the doors of experience open for us? Ano ba nangyayari when the doors of experience opens for us? What happens? Number one, we focus on the blessing. That's our instinct. Instantly, wow, ang dami nating blessing. Let's focus on it. Let's get what we could have. Let's get for our family. Let's get the blessing for tomorrow. Let's get the blessing for our future. We focus on the blessing. Okay, kailangan natin yan. Let's put everything, all the fish inside the boat. But you know what? As we focus on the blessing, as we just look into the blessing, what happens? We forget about the blesser. Nakalimutan na natin kung sino yung nag-bless. Sino po ba nag-bless sa atin? Si Jesus, di ba? Si God, the God, the Father who had really blessed us. And sometimes when the blessing is already there, we forget about the blesser. We forget to thank Him. We forget na kailangan natin siyang puntahan, kailangan natin sumimba ulit. Kasi may iba siguro, nung sumisimba, nagpe-pray talaga, pero nung na-receive na yung blessing, hindi na naman sumisimba. So, pakitanong nga yung katabi mo, ikaw ba yun? Sana hindi ikaw yun. So, we forget about the blesser. We forget to praise and worship our God already. So, yung bata po siguro, sa ushers, could I just ask help for the kid? And you know what? We forget about the blesser. So, when we forget about the blesser, what happens? The blessing turns into a curse. That's what happens. The blessing turns into a curse. Sayang, nandun na yung blessing eh. Open na yung door for us. Kaya lang sayang, naging curse pa for each and every one of us. Kaya tama po yung pinapagawa sa atin ni Lord right now is for us to plunge into me, sabi ng Panginoon. Plunge into me. That's what Peter did. He plunged into the Lord. And when he plunged into the sea, ano pong ginawa niya? When he plunged there, sabi niya, sinuot niya na yung outer garment niya. And ang nasa decision niya, it's in his heart, and it's in his mind. Wherever Jesus goes, wherever Jesus moves, whatever Jesus tells me, I'm ready to go. I'm ready to follow Jesus wherever He is. At pakitanong nga yung katabi mo, ikaw ba yun, kapatid? I pray tayo po yun that if we were able to cast our net into the sea, may we be able also to cast ourselves, plunge ourselves into the Lord if we really believe our God. Amen? Amen. And you know what? Last month, you know what? God had been blessing Church of God Marriott Manila. Do you see that? Do you experience that today? Parang di kayo nabe-bless, ha? Are you blessed today? Amen. Yan, di ba? We are blessed. So sa statistics natin, I would just like to show you our status of Church of God for the last month. So this is our attendance for the last weeks of January. So in January 1, we have 115. In January 8, we had 155. In January 15, 178. Akala natin yan na yung peak natin. Medyo bumaba ng 149. But last January 29, we had a record-breaking of 221 in attendance. Sige po, palakpakan po natin si Lord for that. And not only in the terms of membership, but also in terms of our tithes. So this is our tithes for the first week, 23,000, 36,000 for the second week, 26,000 for the third week, fourth week, 24,000, and in the last week, we also had 62,000 in our tithes and offering. Isn't God good? Amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ng Panginoon. God has been blessing our church. God has been with us, and grabe, God is really in this church, and I believe that God will continually bless our church. So this is our status for the last month, and God is good. But you know what? If we're just gonna focus on this, we're just gonna focus on the blessing, we're all getting it wrong. Because these are just numbers, these are just amounts. And ang sabi sa atin ni Lord, Vision 500, I could give it to you this year. Amen po ba yun? 221 nga naabot natin just last month. So how much more in the next months to come? God is very much easy. The blesser, it's not hard for Him to fill this place, this whole place today, if we just focus on the blesser. So how could we focus on the blesser? How could we plunge into the blesser? Well, Church of God Marriott Manila opens its doors for you So if you're there, if you're having that burden, kasi dumadami na rin yung congregation, we're 200, and iilan pa lang yung leaders and workers of the church, well, Church of God Marriott Manila opens these doors of experience for you. So kung ikaw po yung marunong kumanta, you could join the praise and worship team. If you know how to play any instrument, you could join the musicians. If you're a dancer, you could join the dancers. Stage management, evangelism. Kung sino po dito ang willing to share the word of God outside the premises of this church, you are very much welcome. If you're a dad, if you're a mom, you're also welcome to join these experiences. If you're the youth, you could join the youth empowered ministry. If you're here na ushering, gusto mong kumamay kamay, nakita niyo po medyo kulang po yung ating workers sa pagkakamay, kulang po yung smile, you could join these experiences. If you're good in social media, if you're a blogger, you could join this ministry. If you're a part of the multimedia and you know how to do some designs, you could also join here. If you're passionate about the kids, sino po bang mga passionate about the kids? Ako medyo kasi impatient ako, so baka hindi ako bagay dyan. So you could join the kids. If you want to be a part of the administration team, all these experiences are open for you. The church had opened it for you. And if you're saying, Lord, I want to plunge into you. I want to be part of something bigger and better. Lord, I don't like na yung doors ko are still locked. Here are the doors. It's for you to plunge into it. Amen po ba yun? Pakisabi mo nga sa katin mo, samahan mo naman ako. Amen. So samahan niyo po ang bawat isa, for these doors are very much open for you. And what happened? What happened to Peter in the next verse, in verse 10 to 11, when he just plunged into Jesus? And that, what did he say? Jesus said to them, bring some of the fish which you have just caught. Ito na, inutusan niya na si Peter to do something. And what happened? Simon Peter went up and dragged the net to land full of large fish, 153. And although there were so many, the net was not broken. So for the past minutes, yung mga disciples, they were having a hard time to lift the net. They were having a hard time to lift the net going to land. But when Jesus told Peter, Peter, get all those fish here in the land, what happened? It was so easy for Peter to bring the blessings to land. 153, how did this guy do it? And you know what? This is God's word for us. The blessing is easy to carry when God carries it for you. Amen? Amen. Sige po, let's give God a clap offering. The blessing is very much easy to carry when God carries it for you. Kasi minsan yung blessing, overwhelming po, di ba? Pag nag-uumapaw masyado yung blessing, sometimes we're having a hard time to handle it. We're having a hard time to carry it. We don't know what to do with the blessing pag sobrang dami. But when God carries it for you, it's so much easy to carry. And one thing else, when Jesus carries it for you, He adds no trouble unto it. Amen? It's pure blessing. Wala kang kaaway, wala kang matatapakan. All the blessing, all for you because it came from God. At kapag si Lord po nagbigay, grabe, the net was not broken. Kayang-kaya mo saluhin every bit of the blessing because it came from God, because you focused on the blesser. Amen? Amen. So that's what God is telling us right now. And finally, in the next verse it says, in verse 12, it says here, so Jesus said to them, come and have breakfast. So gusto niyo po ba maka-breakfast si Jesus? Amen. Sarap ng experience na yun, no? So come and have breakfast, sabi ni Jesus. And it says here, but none of the disciples dared ask him, who are you? Because they already knew that it was the Lord. So, but kaya, why are they not, why don't they dare ask who this guy is? So, this is how they look like. So, Jesus was at the center, and the disciples were around him, and they were shy to ask who that guy is, because they already know. Why? Kasi ano bang meron tong disciples? Who are these disciples? Number one, these disciples are people of little faith as well. So, just like you, just like me, in their lifetime, in their years of serving God, they also have that little faith. So pare-parehas lang po tayo. And not only that, these disciples, do you remember that they abandoned Jesus? You remember that? When Jesus was betrayed, when the soldiers came into Jesus and his disciples, kinuha po si Jesus, and what is it said in Matthew? The disciples abandoned Jesus and they fled. Iniwan po nila si Jesus in his time of trial, in his time of testing, in his greatest challenge. Ano po nangyari sa disciples? Naglaho, parang bula. Iniwan po si Jesus. Kaya po, because of that, because they did this, di ba na-experience yun na ba yun? Nagmahal na po ba kayo? Tatawa yung mga youth. Nagmahal na, di ba? Tapos, parang naramdaman mo na rin iniwan ka or nang iwan ka, di ba? So what happened to these guys? Si Jesus pa mismo yung iniwan nila. Si Jesus pa mismo yung sinakta nila na minahal na sila ng sobra. And what happened? They lived a bitter life after it. Kasi they could not take it eh. They could not take what they've done to Jesus. Totoo naman eh, mahal na mahal nila si Jesus, pero iniwan nila. So naging bitter sila. Pakitanong nga katabi mo, bitter ka ba? So kung wala kang kadate sa Tuesday, punta ka sa Jollibee, hanap ka ng best friend mo, di ba? Napanood ko kasi kahapon yung video ng Jollibee, so share natin sa inyo. So they lived a bitter life. The disciples also experienced a bitter life. And because they lived a bitter life, wow, they forgot everything about doors of experience. Kinalimutan nila, oh, wala nang paki dyan sa doors of experience. This is me, I'm gonna live a bitter life, and I'm okay to live this bitter life till the end of my life. But when Jesus saw it, still, Jesus came. Jesus came, sir, the verse. Jesus came to the disciples. And when Jesus saw them, Jesus saw that, what are you doing, disciples? Why are you wasting your life? Why are you contented in living in bitterness, in living in this bitter life? So Jesus came to them and gave them bread and gave them fish and gave them a new experience. Here I am. I'm showing myself to you. This is the resurrection power. This is the unbelievable experience. And I'm personally sharing it to you. And I'm offering something to you today. At ano po yung ino-offer ni Lord sa kanila in the midst, in the depth, in the deepest part of their bitterness? What is God? What is Jesus telling them? I'm offering you something. Come to me and have breakfast with me that you may live life to the fullest. Sige po, palakpangan po natin si Lord. This is what Jesus is offering to you as well. Come and have breakfast with me. Come to me that you may live life to the fullest. Because when you're in God's presence, that's the best place that you could be, when you plunge into Him, in His presence. And this is the last verse. In verse 14, it says here, as I call on the worship team right now, in verse 14, it says, this was now the third time Jesus appeared to His disciples after He was raised from the dead. So right now, we could ask, That was my question a while ago, the weeks before, the days before, about this. Bakit nga ba? Why is Jesus showing Himself to the disciples? Why is Jesus performing all these miracles for the disciples? Bakit ba paulit-ulit na nagpapakita siya that I am risen, I have resurrected, this is my power? Bakit ba niya paulit-ulit ginagawa yun? Why is He doing that? He's doing that just for you to believe. That's the only reason why He's doing that, for you to believe. To believe again. And He's doing that, why? Because when you believe again, when you simply believe in Jesus, you get to live life to the fullest. You get to live life to the fullest. And people may think that we're crazy to be here in a hotel. We planted a church in Marriott Manila Hotel. And it's crazy. Why? Because hindi biro yung rent, hindi biro yung investments, and it's really high. And people could say, nako, hindi yan tatagal dyan. Siguro mga 2 years lang yan. Or 1 year. Wala na yan, alis na yan sa Marriott kasi masyadong mahal yung price dyan. It's crazy. Sana you just give it to other people. To plant other, more and more and more churches. But why are we here? Why are we crazy to be here? What's the point? All these stuff, all the reasons why we are here in Marriott, Manila is for you. It's all worth it. Hindi sayang lahat ng ginagawa natin dito if you will be led to believe again. If you will be able to believe again. At hindi sayang lahat ng ginagawa natin dito in our church if this church will lead the people outside this church in the city to believe again and to live life to the fullest. Amen po ba dun? We just give God our very best clap offering. That's God's message for us today. To simply believe. Simply believe that you may live life to the fullest. And we're gonna have an altar call today. And if that's you who's right now desperate for an open door, for a door of experience in his life. Na before, ang dami nating questions, ang dami nating doubts, we could not follow with all those baggages in our lives. And right now, God is inviting you, come. Come and have breakfast with me. And we could only come if we will believe again. So if that's you, we're saying, Lord, I want to believe again. So as Jesus Christ invites you to come to the altar, you're free to come and we will pray for you that after this day, we're gonna live life to the fullest. Hallelujah. So as the praise and worship team sings this song, you just are invited by the Lord to come here in front. Hallelujah. So as the worship team sings song, you may come. Hallelujah.
I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge. You are my strength. As I pour out my heart, these things I remember. You are faithful, God, forever. And I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge, you are my strength. As I pour out my heart, these things I remember. You are faithful, God, forever. And I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge, you are my strength.
Yes, you may come.
As I pour out my heart, these things I remember.
You have a hard time the past years.
You are faithful, God.
You don't want to believe again. Now's the time to believe again.
My hands to believe again. You are my refuge, you are my strength. As I pour out my heart, this things I remember. You are faithful, God, forever. I lift my hands to believe strength as I pour out my heart. These things I remember. You are faithful.
Can you just lift your hands? Lift your hands as you worship Jesus.
And I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge, you are my strength. As I pour out my heart, these things I remember. You are faithful, God, forever. So let faith arise.
We just raise up our hands to God. This is an act of surrender. It's an act of believing that the one to whom we are surrendering is the true and one true and living God. And He's really the blesser of our lives. That we may experience what we've never experienced before. That we may do things, amazing things, through the power of our God. If you join me in this prayer today, Lord Jesus Christ,
Lord Jesus Christ,
I come to you today.
I come to you today
with much humility.
With much humility.
Lord,
Lord,
I decide today.
I decide today
not to ask questions anymore.
Not to ask questions anymore.
No more doubting, Lord.
No more doubting, Lord.
Only believing.
Only believing.
Today, Lord.
Today, Lord.
I want to believe again.
I want to believe again.
Whatever happened to me.
Whatever happened to me.
In the past years.
In the past years.
All the pain.
All the pain.
All the discouragement.
All the discouragement.
All the frustration.
All the frustrations.
It's over, Lord.
It's over, Lord.
Today.
Today.
It's a new start.
It's a new start.
I could believe again.
I could believe
again. I will simply believe.
I will simply
and
believe.
Live life.
And live life.
To the fullest.
To the fullest.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
Just give God our very best clap offering today. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. And right now, we'll just raise up our tithes and offering once again to our God. So these tithes, we lift up our tithes and offering because we believe that these tithes goes up to heaven for the Lord. Not for just for us, but for the Lord. Gagamitin to ng Panginoon to do more things, to do more amazing things for our lives. This is our act of worship to Him. And could I invite everybody to please stand up and let's raise up our tithes and offering to Him. Lord Jesus Christ, our God, thank you for these tithes and offering. Lord God, thank you, Lord God, for giving us the heart to believe, Lord God, because we will not be able to give, Lord God, if we wouldn't believe. And right now we believe, Lord God, that this is our act of worship. This is our act of love. Lord God, this is for you, Lord God, and we will follow you. No questions asked, Lord God. No more doubts, just following you in our lives, Lord God. And Lord Jesus Christ, Lord God, thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you for this beautiful service. Lord God, thank you for your wonderful word once again to our lives, Lord God. And Lord God, thank you, Lord God, for teaching us again to believe. And right now, Lord God, we will continually believe, Lord God, because we want to enter the doors of experience in our lives, that we may live life to the fullest. Lord God, thank you very much, Lord God, and we just claim the victory, and we give you back all the glory and all the praise in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. God bless everyone. Have a blessed week ahead. Hallelujah.